Along the U.S.-Mexico border in southern New Mexico, there's not a river or landforms that divide the two countries. It's the same Chihuahuan desert, the same connected aquifers beneath soil and stone, the same creatures leaving their prints behind in the sand.
We know there are a lot of species out here because we've set out wildlife cameras and we've captured videos and photos of them.
The images collected by the Southwest Environmental Center include mountain lions, bobcats, javelinas, deer, coyotes, and foxes. Not only does this wall break up the visual landscape, for the animals that live in this vast Chihuahuan desert, it poses an existential threat.
Wild animals need to move across the landscape to be able to get to the food and the water and the mates that they need to survive and for their kind to survive into the future. This is a classic case of habitat fragmentation, and biologists know that when you fragment habitat, you divide populations of wild animals into smaller populations, and the smaller the population of wild animals, the more likely it is to disappear. And when enough of those populations disappear, the species goes extinct.
The desert here is quiet. But in the past 2 years, construction workers have been erecting 30-foot-tall steel bollards, costing more than $20 million a mile. In some places, the 30-foot wall replaces an 18-foot wall. In others, the border has been nothing but barbed wire fences and vehicle barriers. Kevin Bixby moved here 30 years ago. At that time, the border was a barbed wire fence to keep cattle from crossing the international boundary.
There really was no wall here to speak of. What there was these vehicle barriers that are maybe 4 or 5 feet tall. Really no problem for wildlife to get through. When people say that this administration has not built any new wall, it's not correct.
For centuries, people moved across this landscape too, to trade, travel, follow wildlife, migrate with the seasons, to build lives on either side of a line in the desert agreed upon by two countries. Angelica Rubio is a state lawmaker. She represents the city of Las Cruces.
I was born and raised in the southeastern part of the state, and my parents are actually from the Marfa Presidio area. And so for us, the borderlands has always been a big part of who we are as not only my family, but also our community. And the same can be said about Las Cruces and the South Valley, where so many of the smaller communities leading into El Paso have been a part of generations-long binational communities that have lived together for a very, very long time.
But America began to militarize its southern border, even before the election of Donald Trump in 2016, when the U.S. started granting contracts, each worth hundreds of millions of dollars. And the Trump administration began waiving environmental protection laws for the construction.
When 45 was elected into office a couple years ago, people assumed that the wall was barely going to be built. But what people don't realize is that this part of the region has been heavily militarized for a very long time. Over the course of Clinton's administration, the Bush administration, and even under the Obama administration, we have seen barriers go up.
There are checkpoints throughout southern New Mexico and Border Patrol agents in towns and cities. To Rubio, this makes people in southern New Mexico feel like they are always surrounded by walls. And myths have arisen around the border with Mexico.
I feel that this narrative that this border is insecure and that this border is dangerous is really built on fear from those who are not from here.
Pushing back against these divisive narratives about immigration and the landscape has brought some New Mexicans closer together.
after the election in 2016, there was a lot of unlikely allies, many allies who had worked in silos for a very long time, who came together not only to address issues around human rights, but also to address issues around the protection of our public lands and our wildlife. And we all came together to really think through what was our strategy moving forward and how do we further protect this very diverse area from a wall that is very much going to be destructive to our land and to our wildlife.
Even if immigration policies change in the coming years, the wall will still be a scar. It will still stand here in the desert, in the desert that looks just the same on either side of the border.
Worldwide, we're facing this global extinction crisis where we're losing populations and species of wildlife, and we're losing intact ecosystems everywhere. And as one scientist has said, we're busy sawing off the branch that we're sitting on. Our fate as a species really depends on maintaining the biological diversity of this world.
And walls don't help anyone, Bixby says.
I think it's important for people who don't live here to understand that, first of all, there is no crisis. Secondly, the border wall causes harm to wildlife and the environment. And this is my home, and this is the home of people that live along the border, and it's the home of the wildlife that lives here. And the border wall is not good for any of us.
For Our Land and New Mexico in Focus, I'm Laura Paskus.